This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Hindu.
Ali-based sources confirmed that an army officer is a suspect in the Dilshan case. Meanwhile, army says that the guilty will not be shielded. Expert committee on common syllabus calls the textbook substandard, says common syllabus cannot be implemented in this academic session. AMA launches a fresh sales pitch to industry heavyweights, assures of revamp in state infrastructure and bureaucracy. Jaya heads to Delhi with a long list of demands, power top on the agenda in meeting with the planning commission. Sun Pictures chief COO Saxena to be interrogated under police custody for 2 days. Supreme Court lifts the stay on Justice Dinakaran's impeachment, describes his petition as a delaying tactic. Take out the umbrellas and the raincoats, the Met Department says, get ready for some showers. Well, a very good evening. You're watching Headlines Now with me, Ashwin. Of course, the big story that we are tracking very carefully are the new developments coming in from the Dilshan murder case. Of course, the latest that we hear is that an army officer is on the radar of investigations at this point. We'll, of course, get you all the latest details with the help of our correspondent who's tracking that story very carefully. But up first, national stories that are buzzing at this hour. As the sports minister sacks coaches, an NDTV sting on how chemists outside sports centres stock performance-enhancing steroids. Rahul Gandhi visits Bhatta for salt part of his yatra to Aligarh for the Mahapanchayat on land acquisition. Ahead of the cabinet reshuffle, Murli Deora confirms he has offered to resign. Is this an attempt to pave the way for his son? A 17-year-old girl in Haryana is killed by her father after she refuses to stay with a 55-year-old man. Clashes during the Telangana Band as Congress leaders now acknowledge that it's time for a discussion on a separate state. An outrage after the health minister calls homosexuality unnatural. Gay activists demand an apology. And every actor has the right to their own comfort zone. Katrina Kaif on her much talked about intimate scene with Hrithik Roshan. Well, first up at this hour, in developments coming in from the disturbing Dilshan murder case. From highly placed sources, we have come to learn that army officials have now come on the radar. One of them is being questioned closely. There are reports that the concerned officer is being interrogated by the police. Meanwhile, while the army issued a statement saying that the guilty will not be shielded, they have just revealed that all the weapons and ammunition have been accounted for. Now remember, Dilshan's case was transferred to the city's CBCID, and both police and the army were jointly investigating the murder of a teenager on Sunday inside the army compound. Well, for more on this, let's go across to our crime correspondent who's joining us live over the phone line. Now, Salim, at this point, what are your sources telling you about the latest developments? Army officer on the radar.
Yes, the accused who shot 13-year-old Dilshan is an officer in the Indian Army, and the police sources say that the cell phone tower location of the suspect confirmed his presence at the scene of crime. And the police sources added that initially the army tried to conceal evidence. In fact, the security guard was threatened not to convey any info to the police. But later, as the investigation gained momentum, the security guard cooperated and conveyed everything to the police. And the CBCID officers say that the army extending cooperation only now. And the sources from the CBCID very clearly say that the suspect who have opened the fire, likely to be arrested any time now. Ashmit?
Now, interesting observations these that your sources are telling you, of course, about the involvement of this one army officer. Now, in the context of the army reactions, they have been very tight-lipped about it. They have been rhetorical. How does this, what kind of a position do these developments put the army in?
Yeah, the army have been sending press release saying that we are completely cooperating with the CBCID officers, and the local police point this and say that initially they did not cooperate well, and they tried to conceal evidence, and that's why when they have started cooperating, they have been sending press release from the army to all the press people to say that they are extending their cooperation to the CBCID. Ashmit?
Right now, Salim, just a final question at this point. Of course, the road forward right now, what direction do the investigations appear to be taking at this point? What are your sources telling you in terms of course, people that will be held responsible and, of course, the charges that will be framed?
Yes, sources from the CBCID very clearly say that this is a case of murder and they may add another section, illegal use of weapon. But the CBCID police say they have not decided so far. But according to the sources from the CBCID, the suspect is 99%. The CBCID says that they have zeroed in on the suspect 99%, and the investigations are on. And once they are confident, once they have enough evidence that this particular officer is the suspect, and they will automatically go for the arrest, which is likely to happen anytime now.
Right, Salim. Thanks a lot for joining us. We'll, of course, be coming back to you shortly for lots more updates, of course, on this one developing story. Now, of course, ever since Dilshan was shot in the head on Sunday afternoon in the defense compound in Chennai, the question on everyone's mind is who fired the shot? More importantly, where did he go? Did anyone catch him? Did anyone shoot Dilshan at all? Watch this.
Shot dead on a Sunday. But the only weapon carried in this compound does not require bullets, or so they say.
In our colony here, in fact all our colonies here, we do not have any armed guards. Even now, if you go to our main gate and see, the guards are outsourced civilians. They have got only a danda in their hands. They got a stick in their hands. There is no weapon which is authorized to come into any of these colonies, and we have been checking all through. No weapon has been deployed in this colony so far.
After public outrage, the army has been talking to the media, but try decoding for any nugget on progress of the probe. On Monday morning, in an army chief statement, Lieutenant General A.S. Lamba, vice chief of the army staff, stated, and I quote, "The local station commander made a statement yesterday and there is no armed guard in that area. We are fully cooperating with the civil police and you will know soon." And there was no more of code silence army style later on Monday evening. Tamil Nadu Chief Minister Jayalalitha says no one could have mistaken the boy for a terrorist. But the army believes in closing ranks and the latest statement reveals nothing at all. Clearly, the rank and file believes in falling in line. And maybe we may all have to wait for Rajkumar Gupta to make his next film titled No One Killed Dilshan. In Chennai with Bama Ravi, Natasha for NDTV Hindu.
Well, moving on to another story now. This is one report card that the student community will be eager to get a hold of. The one filed by the 9-member expert committee on the uniform syllabus, which was filed in the Madras High Court today. Our principal correspondent P. Mohammed brings to us what the panel has recommended.
Substandard, that is the expert opinion on the existing uniform syllabus by the 9-member expert committee. It also says the syllabus provides neither equity nor quality education, nor does it follow the National Curriculum Framework 2005 and does not warrant the books prescribed for the academic year 2011-2012, since a number of modifications are required.
Now the committee has examined and they have submitted the report to the Registrar General of Madras High Court. Now the matter is posted to 7th for day-to-day proceedings.
The panel says the study plan leans towards rote learning, not analytical thinking. But as the case comes up for hearing from Thursday, these arguments may be challenged.
From Thursday onwards, it will be taken up on day-to-day basis and an order is expected as soon as possible. And the Chief Justice said it should not take more than 10 days.
But the impasse over which textbooks to use should come to an end soon. With the court hearing the case on a daily basis, will the expert panel get pass marks? One way or the other, students want an answer. In Chennai, with Peer Mohammed, Cuckoo Alex for NDTV Hindu.
Well, moving ahead now, in a meeting with the National Council of the Confederation of Indian Industries, or CII, Chief Minister Jayalalitha launched into a fresh sales pitch for investment in the state. With growth and investment both taking a hit in Tamil Nadu in the recent years, the new government is only too eager to regain the lost momentum while conceding that several issues are hurting the industries Amma assured potential investors that the power crisis situation in the state would be dealt with to help sustain industrial growth.
I am aware of the nervousness in some sections of the corporate sector arising out of some recent unfortunate power cuts. I take this opportunity to assure you that my government is seized of this issue and we are taking efforts on a war footing to correct the situation. Very soon, we will be able to make our state a power surplus state once again.
Well, meanwhile, Amma admitted that various infrastructural deficits were beginning to hurt the industries, terming them as primary challenges. She spoke on how the state was committed towards overcoming the bottlenecks.
It remained as one of the leading states in manufacturing till 2006. However, subsequently, in recent years, the performance of Tamil Nadu in attracting investments declined. My government is aware of the many challenges industry faces, like the infrastructure deficits. The central challenge lies in improving the investment climate, that is, in providing sound regulation of industry, including the promotion of competition, overcoming bureaucratic delay and inefficiency, and improving the quality of infrastructure.
Well, at the same conference, Jayalalitha also welcomed the theme of National Council of the CII, Business for Livelihood. Expressing fears over inequitable distribution of wealth, she reinforced that her strategies were oriented towards the common man. She also expressed confidence in achieving the Millennium Development Goals well before 2015.
Tamil Nadu made significant progress in poverty reduction and was ranked ahead of states like Maharashtra, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, etc. My dream is to totally eradicate poverty and unemployment in Tamil Nadu. These goals are more ambitious than even the Millennium Development Goals. We are confident of achieving MDG targets. We are confident of achieving MDG targets before 2015.
Well, staying with news on the Chief Minister Jayalalitha, she is expected to leave for Delhi tomorrow morning. She is expected to participate even as the Planning Commission looks to finalise the annual plan. Now, according to sources, she has plans to meet Planning Commission Vice President Montek Singh Ahluwalia. Issues such as power, state debt and cash assistance by the centre are expected to feature in the talks. Jayalalitha returns to the city by Wednesday night itself, the second visit to the capital in fact. She already had visited Delhi to meet Prime Minister on June 14th. And well, in the latest involving the arrest of Sun Pictures COO Saxena, he will be interrogated in police custody for 2 days. Saxena was arrested on Sunday following allegations of cheating. Following the arrest, the police had moved the court seeking 5 days custody. The bail hearing for Saxena is due to be heard on the 7th.
அது வரும் 7ஆம் தேதி 4 மணிக்கு மீண்டும் எதிரியை நீதிமன்றத்தில் அதே நிலையுடன் ஒப்படைக்க வேண்டும். இதுதான் வரும். அந்த பெயில் அப்ளிகேஷன் அவர் போட்ட பிணை மனு 7ஆம் தேதிக்கு மேல் நீதிமன்றத்தால் பரிசீலனை செய்யப்படும். அவர்கள் வந்து கூட வழக்கறிஞரை வைத்துக் கொண்டோம் என்று முறையிட்டனர். அது நீதிமன்றத்தால் நிராகரிக்கப்பட்டது.
And well, still ahead on the bulletin, in a shocking revelation, despite the uproar about doping by athletes, we show you how the proliferation of such drugs is only too commonplace on the other side.